The emergence of Homo Heidelbergensis, around 700,000 to 600,000 years ago in southern Africa, coinciding with the transition from the old Acheulean tool-making tradition to the new Acheulean, is recognized as the fourth major transformation in the evolutionary path of humans. Before the discovery of African specimens, the Heidelberg species was first introduced in 1908. This introduction was based on the fossil of a remarkably well-preserved lower jaw, found in a sand pit near the village of Mauer, close to the city of Heidelberg in Germany. This jawbone is estimated to be around 500,000 years old. Subsequent archaeological excavations, which uncovered more fossil specimens and the shared morphological features of these specimens with Homo ergaster, suggest that this species initially evolved through speciation of Homo ergaster in Africa. It then migrated out of the continent and spread across various regions of the ancient world. The major difference between Homo heidelbergensis and Homo ergaster is the increased brain size of Homo heidelbergensis. This species had a brain volume of about 1,100 to 1,200 cubic centimeters, which is relatively large, although still not comparable to the average brain size of modern humans. Homo heidelbergensis had a prominent face with forward-projecting features, situated beneath a thick brow ridge, and exhibited little evidence of a chin. Language is the most distinctive ability of Homo sapiens compared to other creatures. Therefore, to understand how the unique features of modern humans emerged, it is essential to determine when our ancestors became capable of speech. The morphology of the base of the skull in Homo heidelbergensis suggests that even around 600,000 years ago, this species had some of the necessary potential for producing the sounds required for speech. However, despite this evidence, there remains doubt that the vocal apparatus of Homo heidelbergensis evolved to be fully comparable to that of modern humans, and there is no definitive evidence of their actual ability to speak. The view that Homo heidelbergensis was the common ancestor of early Homo sapiens in Africa, Neanderthals in Europe, and Denisovans in Asia has gained considerable credibility among researchers for some time now. Evidence suggests that this species was present in Europe, and possibly shortly after their arrival, due to climatic changes and being trapped by ice barriers, a speciation process led to the emergence of the first Neanderthals from the populations of Homo heidelbergensis residing in Europe. Meanwhile, some researchers have recently proposed a hypothesis that the African variant of Homo heidelbergensis, also known as Homo bodoensis, might be the ancestor of Homo sapiens in Africa. This hypothesis requires further investigation, but it has been introduced as one of the noteworthy theories in the study of human evolution. In terms of technology and stone tool making, Homo heidelbergensis did not show significant differences from Homo ergaster and continued to produce Acheulean tools. Only in the later stages of the Lower Paleolithic did the shape of Acheulean tools become more refined. This change relatively indicates the use of flaking techniques with a wooden or bone hammer as a soft hammer instead of a stone or hard hammer, leading to straighter edges and more organized designs in the tools. Until the mid-1990s, most scientists believed that these hominins lacked complexity and specific skills in hunting. However, a remarkable discovery in 1995 at Schöningen, Germany, challenged this view. Wooden tools are rarely preserved over time and seldom become part of the archaeological record because they typically last only 1 or 2 years, leaving no trace after several millennia. However, in a peat bog at Schöningen, along with stone tools and animal bones bearing deliberate cut marks, several wooden spears dating back 400,000 years were found, miraculously well preserved, as well as several pieces of wood with indentations that likely served as handles for stone tools. The spears, approximately 2 meters long, were made from spruce wood and crafted from the lower part of the tree trunk, which contains the hardest wood. Their tips were carefully sharpened to enhance their effectiveness in hunting. Each spear was skillfully crafted, and their design indicated that these objects were intended for throwing rather than thrusting. The shape of these spears reveals that their makers, contrary to the expectations and assumptions of archaeologists, were equipped with more sophisticated hunting techniques. Before the Schöningen discovery, the oldest wooden tool was a spear dating back 125,000 years, found in another site in Germany called Leringen. This spear, recovered from the bones of a giant extinct elephant, was considered a thrusting weapon intended for close-range attacks. However, the Schöningen discovery indicates that hunters of that era may have used their spears for throwing from a safe distance at their prey, representing a major advancement in hunting techniques. Scientists believe that the mastery of effective hunting methods by these hominins in Northern Europe, especially under the challenging conditions of the region, played a crucial role in their success. Large and robust mammals in these areas were a vital source of food for hominins throughout much of the year. Some researchers believe that this hominin was the first to have the ability to live relatively long-term in fixed locations, even in the highly seasonal and variable environments of mid-latitude Eurasia. To better understand the daily life of these hominins, one should refer to a site called Terra Amata on the Mediterranean coast of France. This site, dating back 350,000 years, was likely a coastal camp used seasonally by Ice Age hunters. Stone tools, animal bones, and ash deposits all provide evidence of hominin activity at this site, along with indications of shelter. These findings, along with similar evidence from the 350,000-year-old site of Bilsingsleben in Germany, are recognized as the oldest architectural evidence in the world. The excavators at Terra Amata have reconstructed this preserved shelter. This shelter, with a length of over 8 meters and an elliptical floor plan, was constructed using stones around its perimeter to reinforce and stabilize the structure. Wooden materials met at the center of the structure to form its roof. Insulation with animal hides is a matter of speculation, and the excavators of the site do not place much confidence in this theory. Inside the hut, right at the entrance, there is a shallow pit containing ash, animal bones, and burnt stones, as well as evidence of a stove-like structure, indicating the use of fire for cooking meat. These findings are among the earliest evidence of fire use and control by hominins. Earlier videos mentioned that the oldest continuous evidence of fire use and control, dating back approximately 790,000 years, was found in a Heidelberg hominin site in Israel. In 1921, a fossilized skull of Homo Heidelbergensis was discovered in Zambia, Africa, known as the Kabwe, or Broken Hill skull. During World War I, British soldiers had used this skull as a target for shooting, and the marks from the bullets are still visible. However, it was later determined that it belonged to a very rare hominin specimen estimated to be between 125,000 and 300,000 years old. A hole in the upper jaw of this hominin indicates a severe dental infection, which could have contributed to its death. The Kabwe specimen features one of the largest and thickest brow ridges among all hominin specimens discovered worldwide. In 1976, a skull from the Bodo site in Ethiopia, Africa, was discovered and is known as Homo Bodoensis. This skull, dating back approximately 600,000 years, has a brain volume of 1,250 cubic centimeters. An interesting aspect of this skull, aside from its age, is the presence of cut marks with stone tools near the left eye socket. These marks suggest the possibility that this hominin might have been subjected to cannibalism. One of the most famous archaeological sites related to Homo heidelbergensis is the Cima de los Huesos in Spain. This site, which was once a pit, contains the remains of at least 32 hominins that were thrown into it after death. The bones of these individuals, mixed with those of other animals such as cave bears, have cemented over the years, which is why the site's name in Spanish means bone pit or cave of bones. Spanish archaeologists have been excavating this site for about 15 years. But perhaps one of the most mysterious discoveries at Cima de los Huesos is skeleton number 5, better known as Miguelón. This individual, who died around the age of 30, had suffered 13 blows to the head, likely leading to broken teeth and a severe infection, sepsis, that ultimately caused his death. Even more intriguing is the spherical depression on the frontal bone, suggesting a blow delivered by a club or a rounded stone tool, most likely wielded by a right-handed individual. Was this evidence of a violent conflict, or was it an accident? And does the accumulation of bones in the pit hint at one of the earliest known burial practices? While the findings at Cima provide answers to many questions, they also leave us with many new ones yet to be solved. In East Asia, particularly in China, at sites like Dali and Jinshan, human fossil remains have been discovered that exhibit more advanced morphology than what is attributed to Homo erectus. Scientists are currently investigating whether these specimens could be classified under Homo Heidelbergensis. It appears that Homo Heidelbergensis may have coexisted with Asian Homo erectus for a significant period after their arrival in East Asia. These populations eventually became extinct, although genetic studies suggest the possibility of genetic exchange among ancient populations predating Homo sapiens in East Asia.